Live from downtown Bakersfield, 23 ABC News at 11 starts now.
Your decision to get behind a wheel while intoxicated can affect other people and other people's lives, and you're not the only one on the road.
A plea for change from local families who have lost everything as a result of a driver deciding to get behind the wheel drunk. This weekend, hundreds expected to gather for the Mothers Against Drunk Driving walk to raise awareness about the dangers of drunk driving. 23 ABC's Amanda Mason introducing us to a young woman who knows firsthand what it's like to lose someone to an avoidable tragedy. Amanda?
Well, according to Matt, on average, every day, 11 drivers are arrested for drinking and driving in Kern County. It was a drunk driver in August of 2014 that changed the lives of three young women who were out for a baseball game and fireworks.
Well, it's hard to tell my story, but if it helps someone, it's worth it.
4 years ago, a deadly crash took the lives of two young women and left one survivor, Jessica Magee.
We were on our way home from a Bakersfield Blaze baseball game.
Magee and her two best friends, Jackie Kaznica and Pavinder Clare, were together as usual when they were hit from behind. Police say Dontrell Collins was drunk and high on PCP at the time of the crash, leaving the three girls in a mangled car.
We were trapped in the car while it was on fire.
The car exploded. Magee able to get out, but Kaznica and Clare didn't make it.
It wasn't our fault for the accident. It was someone else that was drinking and got behind the wheel. We were the ones affected.
Magee says she misses her two best friends every day and treasures the memories they left behind.
Jackie taught me to never give up. She was trying to make her life better because she always wanted to help people. So she always taught me, you know, to be kind and don't give up, and whatever happens, you know, always find the bright side. And even with Pavinder, she taught me that there's always a reason to smile, even through the dark times.
Magee went on to face Collins in court and testified about the night she lost her best friends. Collins was found guilty and sentenced to 73 years in prison.
I'm a survivor. This is what I've been through, but I'm not gonna let it control my life. And no matter what, I know that since I survived this, I can survive anything else.
She says she's grateful for Mothers Against Drunk Driving, who were there with her and her family every step of the way. Now she continues to honor her best friends' lives by taking part in the annual Walk Like Mad event. Her first time ever participating was shortly after the crash. She hopes her story will save somebody else from the pain she's gone through.
It actually affects a whole community when someone gets behind a wheel. It affects the people that they live with, their families, their friends, and their coworkers.
And as Magee mentioned, when someone is killed by a drunk driver, it doesn't just affect that person. On Saturday morning, we'll introduce you to Magee's mother and one of her best friend's parents to hear how that crash 4 years ago changed their lives. In studio, Amanda Mason, 23 ABC.
Powerful story there, Amanda. Thank you so much for that. The Walk Like Mad and Mad Dash, scheduled to be held this Saturday. It's set to start at 7:30 Saturday morning at the park at Riverwalk. The event helps raise awareness of the problems of DUI locally and to raise funds for MAD, Kern County's educational program, and to support victims and survivors.